Hi, welcome to Quirky Queen's Journals. My name's Kirsten. So some of you know I got a big shot plus to use as a sort of craft, sort of makeshift printmaking press. I did buy a sort of, it's a longer version of this board, this big board, and this felt blanket from handprinted.co.uk for £25, and I've already got paint on the blanket. But do you know, if I do it all the time and I get really proficient at it, I can always replace it, but for the purposes of learning, it's fine. Now, obviously this isn't what this is designed for, so do so at your own risk. But anyway, I'm going to show you how I'm getting on and what I've done and what I'm going, how I'm doing it. It's using scrappy bits of paper. We're not making lots of effort here paper wise. This is jump rings, you know, that they make jewellery with. I made a little makeshift. I love this. This is my, some of my lino cuts, and this is a sort of lace. So I do find it, see things like, you know, when you make a lot of stuff for the gel plate, I put tissue paper around it. I do find that kind of sticks to the paper when I lift it off. So that's something to bear in mind. And also, this is aluminium foil, and I had been using it on the gel plate, so it had white acrylic paint on it. As you can see, some of the bits of acrylic paint have come off onto here. But I'll know that for next time. This is just sort of corrugated cardboard with bits of old stencil, bits of wire net, and just bits and pieces kind of mod podged onto it. And this is how I sent all the paint up the top. I put too much paint on it. So what I found was I was braying the paint on with the brayer, you know, onto the collograph thing to print. But what I found was actually it's better if I put the paint on the gel plate and lift it off on the gel plate. I get a more even distribution, and I'm not having this level of mishap. So, but I'm really pleased with how clear that is. But anyway, I'm just going to show you a couple just now. I'm going to do this lace first, this little doily. I'm just going to get out the gel plate, and what I'm using is, I'm using this cheap kids paint, because what I found was when I was using the acrylic paint, it was drying too fast. So by the time I got it over to the big shot, it just wasn't working as well. So, but this stuff, this is what I'm using. So let's, I really am in love with the purples this makes. Except for now I'm going for orange, haven't I? Right, I'm not skinning the orange, we're going to go for a greeny colour. There. And then we're just going to mix it all up. See, the other thing as well is I'm kind of not over mixing it, to be honest, because I am liking, I'm liking the kind of different shades that are coming through. I put a bit of match on there for one little go. Just use this. I am in love with this kid's paint. I actually don't know if I want to go back to acrylic. It's a lot more delicate looking, isn't it? Okay. Right. So, I'm just going to set this down here out the way. This is the bit where you put the keyboard on that I kind of have. You do have this paint, doesn't, it dries fast, but it doesn't dry as fast. I have never used this machine for die cutting or embossing. which is what it's made for. But it comes with two of these clear things. This die cutting board, I think, yeah. Which is a kind of strong plastic board. It also comes with this. That I think this is an embossing board. There's the other clear board. And there's the kind of big board. I got a longer board that came with the sort of felt blanket. But I'm just sticking to using this one just now because of the size. I'm just doing little prints just now. So this oh, I should say, by the way, I learned all this from Sally Hurst, who is a professional printmaker. I've just been watching her YouTube channel. There's also a Facebook group called Craft Press Printmakers. By the time I've learned how to do this properly, I'll need a new machine and new bits and pieces, but it'll be worth it. Obviously, this is like a mangle, so I'm still at the stage of kind of guesstimating how much stuff I need in here. So if I'm using the lino cuts, which are quite thick, as you can see, I only need one of the clear sheets in, and I maybe pad it up with one of the other ones, maybe not. So it is a bit of a trial and error that way. I've been using bits of brown paper. I really should put this back in first. I'm not 100% sure about what the difference is that this blanket makes, but I just know that it does. I'm going to need to roll it to get it in. Okay. Yeah, so I've generally been putting a bit of brown paper in just to sort of protect here in case I have any paint spillage, you know, out the sides. A couple of sheets of this. We're not registering or anything like that. We're basically just doing a one sort of pull print. I'm wondering if that's dried too much now. Feels okay, I've got one turned over, but never mind. And then the bit of paper I'm going to put it on is, I think that's an end paper out of a book. I have a funny feeling that this has dried too much with all my talking. If it has, we'll just print it up again. Now, see when you do this, you can feel it getting tighter, and I've still not reached the stage where I've worked out what's too tight and what's too loose. And then I send it back. You don't need to send it back, it's just easier when you're working in a small space like this. Okay. So we've not had leakage, which is good. It's slightly embossed onto there. So it had dried a bit in parts.
That is lovely.
And it's embossed a bit as well. I'll show you the lino cuts next. I'll do this one. Now, because this is quite thick, I will need to remove one of these big plates here. So I've just took that one out. So I might need to put more paper in to compensate. I'm adding in the red. I've got a bit of the blue and yellow on this brayer still, so I find that gives us a bit of a richer red. I don't have black kids paint, so What I might do here actually is when I'm done is I might brayer it as well. Now obviously for printmaking there's lots of different techniques. There's lots of specific details, you know, like cleaning the sides, getting a very professional picture, I'm doing this purely as just a way of making art at home. Okay, so now I've got a funny feeling that despite the fact I've removed one of them, this might still be too thick because that lino adds a lot of well, I think we've made it. It might not even be thick enough now. And so my paper's wrinkled. So obviously it's not stayed flat, but these are all the things that hopefully with time that I'll, you know, be able to iron out. I have a little table I set that on, but for demonstration purposes I'm having to bring it over here, and I do try quite hard to keep it separated. That stuck to it this time. That's okay. I think there was a lot of acrylic paint on this stamp. But that's okay, because we're going to try it again and we'll use a different paper. But you can see that some of it's transferred. You know what I used for those stamps earlier on? I used an envelope. That's what I'm going to use again. Stuck again. I think it's that lino block, because the ones I used earlier on I didn't have this problem at all with. Okay. Now I've made this with stencils, and that is actual printmaking ink on it, but I don't really like using it. I find it hard to work with, which is why I'm preferring to use this kids poster paint. So I'm going to need a lot more paint to put on this one. Okay, I'm going to lay it on the gel plate and I'm going to roll it out. Okay, well we've got a lovely print on the gel plate. I'm going to have to pick that up. I love this kids poster paint. It's just, honestly, look at that. Every detail, honestly, I just love it. I keep saying honestly. That's when you know I'm excited. Honestly, honestly. Right, let me put out some more. Now, I'm thinking to myself, should I have done this double layer? Are the paints in the bits where they shouldn't be? I don't know. But the only way I'm going to find out is by actually doing these things. So let's put that away. I don't think there's any chance it'll look nearly as good as that. Oh, I really hope so, because that would be amazing. Right, this one is... I'm going to need to put one of the plates back in, and I'll probably put in the green one because it's not as thick as the clear one. So the lace was a bit like a sheet of paper. But the collagraph does have some thickness to it, but not nearly as much as the, I do need to move this one quite a bit actually, because this is quite a big collagraph I'm putting in, isn't it? So I should start cleaning off the edges, so that, like, leaving a big border, because then what that will do is it should mean that any excess paint that gets pushed out, it's got a border to go to rather than onto the machine. There's another end page out of a book. It's a bit shiny, this one, so. I don't know, because I've kind of done this, that might affect how it prints, because there's a slight unevenness, but we shall see. Oh. So I think in professional printmaking, you wouldn't roll it back. But obviously, I'm in a limited space situation. Okay. Oh, that, you know, there's not much came out the sides at all, which is good. That's not actually a tear. That's the bit of paper that was at the end. Oh, it's brilliant. It obviously, right, this isn't very clean. Bits of, and bobs have stuck to it. But I think that's amazing. That's just bits of stencil with aluminium foil stuck to it on a book page. Might be a couple of book pages, because it's got a bit of stiffness to it. Well, I'm very happy with that. So what have we made? So we've got the lino cut, the collagraph, and the lace. I don't really know what I did wrong with that time. I just don't think I picked enough paint onto the lace. But anyway. See, if that was registered, you could send that through again with just, you know, a lightly coated. These are the sort of things that I want to be able to learn to do. And to be able to do in a way that I know what I'm doing. So it's going to take time. But anyway, I just wanted to let you know I have actually started, and that kids poster paint, cheap kids paint, is my new favourite paint. It's wonderful. And even the one that came off the gel plate. You definitely pick up more in the craft press, but I mean the gel plate itself, for ease of use and just everything about it, it'll always be my number one. Do you know what it is? I think this is a bit clearer. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and take care, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.